Hello, this is the lecture number 3 for the chapter Binomial Theorem, and we are in the last lecture. We have discussed up to question number 10 of the first exercise. Let us start with the question number 11. You have to find the value of a plus b raised to power 4 minus a minus b raised to power 4, and also you have to find the value of this root 3 plus root 2 raised to power 4 minus root 3 minus root 2 raised to power 4. Now, if you expand it, a plus b raised to power 4, you will get 5 terms, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, simply by using the binomial expansion. And a minus b raised to power 4, again you will get how many terms? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 terms, because we have the power 4. Now if we compare it, the a and b both are same, but we have the difference of only plus and minus sign. So expand a plus b raised to power 4 by using the binomial theorem, we'll get 5 term with combination of 4 0 a raised to power 4. The power of a will goes on decreasing, the power of b goes on increasing because we have the plus sign, so all terms will be positive. Similarly, a minus b raised to power 4, the terms will be same, only the difference between them will be of the positive negative sign. So the first term will be positive, next will be negative, then positive, then negative, then positive. Now you have to subtract these two. This is the minus sign between these two. Now see it carefully. If you subtract this, this will be cancelled out with this. Now this will become of same sign, so this will become 2 times. I've written 2 times combination of 4, 1, a raised to power 3, b. Now this will be cancelled out. This is a minus sign, this is plus, so this will be cancelled out. Now if you open this bracket, this will be negative, this is positive, this will become positive. So these two terms will become, and they will be added. So it become 2 times, that is combination of 4, 3, a, b raised to power 3. And this term will be cancelled out because this is a negative minus sign. And these are same, so this will be cancelled out. So you are getting twice combination of 4, 1, a raised to power 3 plus 4, combination of 4, 3, a, b raised to power 3. Now you know how to form the solve the combination. The combination of 4, 1 will be equal to 4. The combination of 4, 3 will be equal to 4. Multiply and open the bracket. Now because you have to find the value of this, again, if you compare this with this, now you can see that a in place of a we have root 3, and in place of b we have root 2 in first as well as in the second expansion. So what you have to do? You have to simply replace the value of a by root 3 and b by root 2 in the expansion of this. So replace a by root 3 and b by root 2 in this. You'll get the answer of this without individually expanding it. Similarly is the question number 12. X plus 1 raised to power 6, we'll get how many terms? 7 terms. You'll get 7 terms. X minus 1 raised to power 6, again we'll get the 7 term. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. The difference will be only of some minus plus sign. All terms will be positive in this. The even terms will be negative, that is positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative and so on. When you add it, this will be cancelled out with this. This will be cancelled out with this, adding this will be cancelled out this. So you are getting twice of this, you are getting twice of this, and you are getting twice of this. 1, 2 and 3, and it is twice. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So we have 4 terms will be added. You know how to form the combination. Combination of 6, 0, 1, combination of 6, 2, 15 and so on. And using this, you can easily find the value of root 2 plus 1 raised to power 6 plus root 2 minus 1 raised to power 6, replacing the value of x by root 2 in the answer of this. You'll get the answer of root 2 plus 1 raised to power 6 and root 2 minus 1 raised to power 6. So this is the question number 12. Now in question number 13, you have to prove that 9 raised to power n plus 1 minus 8n minus 9 is divisible by 64. By using the binomial expansion. Now see it very carefully. Now I will expand 9 raised to power n plus 1 by using the binomials. For 9 I can write 1 plus 8. For 9 I can write 1 plus 8, and I will use the binomial expansion formula for 1 plus 8 raised to power n plus 1. So see it very carefully. In place of n, we have n plus 1. In place of a, we have 1. In place of b, we have 8 for the formula for the binomial expansion. Because we have n plus 1 terms, power is n plus 1. So the total number of terms in this will be n plus 2. But we don't find all those terms. We'll simply write some term and generalize. So expanded 1 plus 8 x raised to power n plus 1 will be combination of n plus 1, 1, 1 raised to power n plus 1, maximum power of 1, that is n plus 1. Next term will be combination of n plus 1, 1. The power of 1 will goes on decreasing and the power of 8 will be 1, goes on increasing. Combination of n plus 1, 2, 1 raised to power n minus 1, this, and 8 raised to power 2. The next term will be combination of n plus 1, 3, 1 raised to power n minus 2, 8 raised to power 3, and so on. And the last term will be combination of n plus 1, n plus 1, and 8 raised to power n plus 1. These two remaining terms will be as it is, minus 8n, minus 9. Now, if you see it carefully, if you expand this combination of n plus 1, 0, it will be equal to 1, and 1 raised to power n plus 1, it is equal to 1. When you expand this combination of n plus 1, 1, you will get n plus 1. You take your own time to find the value of combination n plus 1, 1 in your rough column, you'll get n plus 1. Or you can learn combination, I just told you in the last question, the combination of n, 1 will be equal to n. So in place of n, we have n plus 1 into 8. And if you see it carefully, from the terms third, you can take 8 square common. 8 square common from this, because the power of 8 is increasing, and so on. You can take 8 square common from this. When you take 8 square common from this, the what will the power of 8 will be? It will be 8n minus 1. When you're taking 8 square common, you'll get the power of n as subtracted 2 from it. It will be n plus 1 minus 2. That is 8n minus 1. These two terms will remain as it is. So except the first two terms, I can take 8 square common from the third terms onward. So it will be combination of n 1 2 8 raised to power 0, combination of n plus 1 3 8 raised to power 1, and in the last term I've already told you. Now this is 1, this is 8n plus 8, and this is minus 8n minus 9. So these terms will be cancelled out with this. 1, 8n, 8n plus 8, this is 9 plus 8n, cancelled out with minus 8 minus 9, minus 8n minus 9, will cancel out it. So we're getting only this 8 square, that is 64, and the terms in the bracket, it is a multiple of 64, so we can say that it is divisible by 64. We can say that it is divisible by 64. Which expression? This expression. I have started this expression. This comes out to be a multiple of 64. So I can say that n raised to power n plus 1 minus 8n minus 9 is divisible by 64. Now in question number 14, see this expression. I'm explaining what is the meaning of this. This summation sign means plus sign. In r goes to 0 up to n means you have to increase the value of r from 0 to n. This summation means you have to add all terms when you increase the value of r from 0 to n. So increase it. First of all, put the value of r as 0 to 0, 0, the combination of n 0, 3 raised to power 0. The next term will be 3 raised to power 1, combination of n 1. The next term will be 3 raised to power 2, combination of n 2. Combination of n 3, 3 raised to power 3, when you goes on increasing the value of r from 0 to n, up to n. Combination of n, 3 raised to power n. It is goes on increasing. So this summation sign means you have to put the positive sign between the terms. So what you are seeing? You are seeing that the power of 3 is goes on increasing. In the binomial expansion, when whose term is goes on increasing is will be the second term of the binomial expansion, that is 3. A plus B raised to power N. A plus B raised to power N, because in terms of N we have N. The power of 3 is increasing, so it must be the second term of the binomial expansion. And the power of none of the term is increasing, so it must be 1 here. 1 raised to power n, 1 raised to power n minus 1, 1 raised to power n minus 2, 1 raised to power n minus 3, and so on, because any power of n will be equal to 1. So there must be 1 here. So 1 plus 3 raised to power n. Now if we expand this, you'll get this again. So it means 4 raised to power n, 4 raised to power n. So this is the question number 14. So this exercise, that is first, is based on only the binomial expansion of the binomial for any positive indices. Now in the next exercise is based on how to find the general term of the binomial expansion without expansion, or how to find the coefficient of any term of the binomial expansion without expanding the binomial, how to find the middle term of the binomial expansion or how to find the any terms of the binomial expansion. So in question number one, exercise 8.2, you have to find the coefficient of x raised to power 5 in the expansion of x plus 3 raised to power 8. Means if you expand x plus 3 raised to power 8, you will get 9 terms, and in one of the term will contain x raised to power 5. You have to find the coefficient of that. So it means if you expand it directly, you will have to use the binomial theorem formula, but it will become lengthy. So we use the general term expansion for x plus 3 raised to power n, and we'll find the coefficient of x raised to power 5. I've already explained to you the general term for the binomial expansion, that is a plus b raised to power n. If it's there, then its general term is tr plus 1 is equal to combination of nr, a raised to power n minus r, b raised to power r. I've explained to you there that the power of first term will be the difference of n and r, and the power of second term is equal to the power of r, that is the binomial expansion. So whenever you have to find the term or the coefficient of any term, then you have to find its general term. So coefficient of x raised to power 4, first of all find the general term. General term is tr plus 1, combination of n r. N here is 8 and r we don't know. X raised to power n minus r, that the first term is x, so it will be n minus r. This is n minus r. And b raised to power r. B raised to power r. B here is 3. Now what you have to obtain here? We need x raised to power 8 minus r is equal to x raised to power 5. We have to find the coefficient of x raised to power 5. So this x raised to power 8 minus r should be x raised to power 5. So I put this x raised to power 8 minus r is equal to x raised to power 5. So when the base are same, the power will be same. The n 8 minus r will be equal to 5. So the r will coming out to be 3. The terms we can find if we know the value of r. So put the value of r here. You will get the coefficient of x raised to power 5. The coefficient will be combination of 8, 3. The value of r is 3 and 3 raised to power 3. This replace the value of r, that is 3. So the coefficient of x raised to power 5 will be except this, that is combination of 8, 3, 3 raised to power 3. Solve this combination, you will get 1, 5, 1, 2. So whenever you have to find the coefficient of any term in the binomial expansion, similarly simply find its general term and then find the value of r. Similarly, you have to find the coefficient of x raised to a raised to power 5, b raised to power 7 in this. To find the general term of this, it will be 1 tr plus 1 minus 1 raised to power r, because it is a negative binomial, combination of nr, x raised to power n minus r, and b raised to power r. In place of a, we have a itself. In place of b, we have 2b. So it will be a raised to power 12 minus r, 2 raised to power r, b raised to power r. Now we need here is a raised to power 5 and b raised to power 7. So put this a raised to power 12 minus r, b raised to power r is equal to a raised to power 5, b raised to power 7. By equating them, 12 minus r equal to 5 and r is equal to 7, you will get the value of r as 7. When you put the value of r 7 in this step number 1, you will get the coefficient of a raised to power 5, b raised to power 7. So put the value of r here. Put it here, put it here, this. Put everywhere the coefficient value of r as 7. The coefficient of a raised to power 5, b raised to power 7 will be minus 1 raised to power 7, combination of 12, 7 and 2 raised to power 7. So expand this combination, you'll get the coefficient of a raised to power 5 and b raised to power 7. So whenever you have to find the coefficient of any term, you have to find the general term. We'll discuss in the next lecture. Thank you.